subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our. Ramadan is like a season. Imagine if you went to a marketplace, as Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala describes it. He goes, look, you've entered the marketplace. In that marketplace, you're dazzled by all these beautiful colors and smells and spices and things. And the movement of the people back and forth, it's all amazing. There's a festivity in that marketplace. And you try to grab whatever you can, and you take your time at the beginning. Why? Because you want to make sure that you get the best out from your money. You don't want to buy right away, so you take your chances. And you try to explore. So you go from one stall to the other one until the end of that season. So when you realize it's the end of that season right now, it's the last day. Most merchants, what do? They give you bargains. They don't want to carry that stuff with them home. They want to give it to you. And they want to make bargains with you. And that's when people start trying to grab whichever bargain they can put their hand on. Because this is my moment right now. My dear brothers and sisters, Ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala is telling us Ramadan is exactly the same way. You had a good bargain in the last 10 days of Ramadan. And you have one single night, the best bargain you can have. And now you have the last few hours. The last few hours. And that's when people can try to put their hands in whatever they can grab from the month of Ramadan. Imagine right now, since Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Ramadan Friday, and then Ramadan is going to end on a weekend. So you have plenty of time probably that you would like right now to catch up on many things you missed out in Ramadan. Some of us might say, I want to catch up with my Quran. Others are going to spend more time in the masjid. Some are going to put more effort in this and that. Everybody's looking for something to put their hand on at the end of Ramadan to be the one best bargain I can come up with, inshallah, ta'ala, by the end of the month of Ramadan. So what am I going to do? I don't have the time to do all what I missed out at the beginning of Ramadan. So if there is anything that is extremely important that we can put our hands on in the month of Ramadan, is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us at the end of every good deed that you do. When you do things with ihsan, you finish them with istighfar. You finish them with seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if there is anything that you need to get yourself busy with in the last few days and hours of the month of Ramadan, is constant state of seeking istighfar and forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In hadith al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa ardah, he spoke about the virtue of Ramadan. Qala, wa yughfaru fihi illa liman aba. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, everybody will be forgiven. Everyone will be forgiven in Ramadan, except for those who refuse. And the Sahaba, they were shocked. Ya Rasulullah, who is it? Who's that person going to refuse to get forgiveness? Qal, ya'ba an yastaghfir Allah. That person who refuses to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which means the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Allah azza wa jal opened the door for forgiveness. You just need to ask for it. You need to go through this door. That's all. And if the doors are still open because Ramadan is not over yet, then the doors of forgiveness are literally open, wide open. And this is the chance that we seize a moment, inshaAllah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, when we seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what we literally ask in Allah azza wa jal is conceal our shortcomings, our mistakes, our errors, and we're full of them. There are many, even in Ramadan. No matter how much we try to make it perfect this year, we still had our own shortcomings, our faults. I don't want my faults in Ramadan to renew everything for me. So I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to conceal that. So that when I present it to Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah subhanahu will show me that which was good about my month of Ramadan, not the faults and the errors. So when you seek forgiveness, it's literally asking Allah to conceal those mistakes and errors and overlook these faults and these mistakes and their errors. Istighfar is one of the best ibadat, the best acts of ibadah and worship you spend your day and night with. It is the attitude of the anbiya and the salihin. That was the behavior of the anbiya, the prophets, and the righteous people. When we go to Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us after we come out from Arafah. Remember, you spend hours and hours in Arafah making dua and seeking forgiveness and asking for Allah's mercy. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ أَفِيدُوا مِنْ حَيْثُ أَفَاضَ النَّاسُ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ. Then you depart from all where the Hujjaj are departing from Muzdalifah, on their way to Mina. He says, وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ. Seek forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal. My dear brothers and sisters, when we finish our salah, the first thing we say is what? Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. My Lord, I seek forgiveness from you. Why? I was engaging in active ibadah. Our ulama, they look into this in a beautiful way. He goes, look, those who went astray and they're far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they only look at their errors and mistakes in the form of what? they only see ma'asi. They see this obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through committing sins. That's how they see their errors. And that's why they only seek forgiveness when they make a mistake. Because the righteous ones, they see that their disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also comes in being negligent, being slow, not being where they're supposed to be. It's not that it's haram that what they're committing, but for them, they say this is not befitting ourselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not befitting Allah azza wa jalla's mighty power, that we should approach Him always, not when we only have that need to seek forgiveness. We seek forgiveness because we can't do enough, because we can't do enough good deeds. And that is the meaning of it when we say astaghfirullah after our salah, astaghfirullah after hajj, and the same thing after the month of Ramadan. We seek forgiveness, maybe not because I've done something wrong, but because I could have done something better. And my Lord, I know no matter what I do, it's never enough, it's never sufficient. So I seek forgiveness for my taqseer, for not being perfect as I should be when it comes to presenting my ibadah to you, my dear Lord. So my dear brothers and sisters, here when it comes to the subject of istighfar, it's not just about making a mistake. It's about completing something good. Even Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom Allah azza wa jalla was pleased with. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testified for us in the Quran on behalf of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he had delivered the message. That he did deliver the message. Allah azza wa jalla commands the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the end of his time to do what? Seek istighfar. Seek istighfar. إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسَ يَدْخُونَ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَاسْتَغْفِرْهُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ تَوَّابًا. When your time is up, that's what Allah said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then you need to praise your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala and seek His forgiveness. So the time for Ramadan is about to be up, and that's the moment when you seek istighfar, forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda, he mentioned something very interesting about that. He goes, look, al-ghiba, backbiting in Ramadan, it punches holes in your ibadah, in your Ramadan. Your Ramadan is whole and perfect, but your misbehavior sometimes, backbiting here, lying here, doing this mistake here and there, punches holes in Ramadan. So it's not perfect anymore. He goes, al-istighfar patches this over for you. It's not going to remove the hole completely, but at least it covers that hole. Hopefully Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept that from you. So he goes, you have done a lot of things that are wrong. So it's about time right now that we recalibrate and see, what did I do wrong? Let me fix that. And if you couldn't find anything wrong, then you look back and say, what could I have done better? And seek forgiveness for not being able to do that. And not taking the chance when you still have it. The last few hours of the month of Ramadan are so unique and so special. Because now, as we come, it's Friday, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. Between Asr time and Maghrib time is a very precious time. That is a time when your dua is most likely to be accepted. So make sure that you spend those last hours, inshallah ta'ala, in seeking forgiveness from Allah azza wa jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands everyone in the Quran to seek forgiveness from Him. وَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about Nuh alayhi salam, ordering his people, seek forgiveness from Allah because He will oft forgive you. He will forgive you. And as a result, يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. You don't just get forgiveness in terms of concealment of your sins and mistakes and errors. No. Allah sends blessing in abundance upon you just because you're seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's the best bargain you come with Ramadan. You got your sins forgiven and concealed. And you're also getting blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah says, Shahadat al-Tawheed taftahu bab al-khayr. He said, look, the testimony of faith, when you say, La ilaha illallah, that opens the door for khayr for you. And he says, Qa wal istighfar yughliqu bab al-shar. And seeking forgiveness from Allah azza wa jal will close the door of evil for you. Why? Because when you seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're admitting your humanness, your weakness, your poverty and need of Allah Azza wa Jal. You admit that. And also give it that sense of reflection and sense of self-awareness and consciousness. And as a result, you realize that, look, if this is something wrong that I'm going to have to seek istighfar, seeking forgiveness for later on, why doing it anyway? Then I better stay away from it. Knowing that you need to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hopefully make you a better person because you realize I need to stay away from these things because eventually they're wrong, I'm going to have to seek istighfar for. Or at least knowing that I should be doing this. If I don't do it, then I need to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So seeking istighfar subhanAllah is the one thing that will help you open the doors for khair and close the door against or evil. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed month of Ramadan to grant us forgiveness, Ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who are forgiven in this month of Ramadan, Ya Allah. We ask Allah to forgive us our sins, that we know of, that which we don't know of. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us our sin, the public and the private, the major and the minor. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us tawbah and repentance by which our sins will be erased and replaced with hasanat, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-azim li wa lakum wa lisal muslimin wa astaghfiruh innahu huwa al-ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا ثم بعد. My dear brothers and sisters, there are so many ways we can seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All acts of ibadat are one way of coming closer to Allah Azza wa Jal, like seeking forgiveness. But at least the minimum, the bare minimum, is to say the words astaghfirullah. At least say astaghfirullah, which means my Lord, I seek forgiveness from you. Or saying Allahumma ghfirli, Ya Allah, forgive me. Just these simple words. Astaghfirullah al-azim wa atubu ilayh. I seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I seek forgiveness from Allah azza wa jal. And I return back to Him. There are many, many ways of seeking istighfar. I urge you today before the end of this day that you look it up. Go look it up. What are the different formats of seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Memorize one or two. Add them to your list of dua inshaAllah ta'ala as we come closer to the month of Ramadan. My dear brothers and sisters, we know as well that we are human beings and we probably have wronged somebody around us. Just like you're seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is also important that you seek forgiveness from those who are around you. Your spouse, your children, your brothers and sisters, your community members, the volunteers of your community over here. If you've done anything wrong, seek forgiveness from the Jama'ah. And on behalf of this community, the volunteers, the staff, myself, the families, and our imams and everyone here, we seek forgiveness from all of you if you've done anything wrong to you. And we ask that you have in your heart, inshallah, the ability to forgive us all and let us know how we can do things better, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. So make sure, make it commitment. By the end of the month of Ramadan, you reach out to all these people that you thought probably maybe I've wronged them. I need to seek forgiveness from them. So we hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us by the end of the month of Ramadan. Allahumma alimna ma yanfa'na wa anfa'na bima allamtana innaka anta al-alimul hakeem. Allahumma aghfir lil-muslimina wal-muslimat والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا. اللهم تقبل منا صيامنا وقيامنا ودعاءنا وذكرنا وتلاوة القرآن. اللهم ثقل بها موازيننا وأعلي درجاتنا واكتبنا في عليين. اللهم احشرنا مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.